The properties of vapor is given. These four properties have given. And which of these two properties, which of these two properties alone are not sufficient to specify the condition of a vapor? Generally, we have seen that to identify the state of any fluid, we need only two properties. And these two properties should be independent of each other. If these two are dependent on each other, then again, these two properties, whichever we consider dependent properties, are not enough to identify the state of any fluid. So these two properties should be independent. That means there shouldn't be any, you know, change of the one variable depending on the other variable. So here, but here in this case, what been asked, if you take any two properties out of these four, then those two properties are not enough to identify the state of the fluid, especially for the vapor. That's what here mentioned in this case. So let's see what does it mean. So I have taken here a simple TS diagram for the phase change of the water, and water started from here and it's going like this, and again it's reaching the vapor state, and this is the water plus vapor. This dome is water plus vapor, and here is a pure vapor. And this, what is this line? This line is constant pressure line. So I carried out the phase change of the water by keeping the pressure at a particular, pressure. So this is the constant pressure line. This is the, you know, constant throughout this process here. And if I take the vapor pressure here, vapor, there are two parts for the vapor. The first one is this one under the dome, where we have a combination of water plus vapor, and another one is this one after the vapor dome. Here this is only the vapor, and in this case we have again two cases. The first one is a saturated vapor, and the second case is the super saturated vapor. So these two cases we need to consider when we deal with this one. And first let's take this one. So we have already know that we need two parameters to identify the state. So if I take this section, and I know the pressure, and if I know the pressure, automatically I can calculate the temperature here. Why? Because I know the saturation. For the saturation value, for the saturation state, the pressure and the temperature are not independent, but they are dependent. Why? Because if you know the value of pressure, automatically you can calculate the value of the temperature. That's what we learn in the theory, thermodynamics theory. And here in this case, again, this temperature is constant throughout the phase change, and pressure also constant throughout the phase change. And if you know pressure at any point, automatically you can calculate the temperature corresponding to the saturation pressure here. Because if I take any point on this line, for example here or here or here, temperature is the same, and that is equivalent to the temperature, saturation temperature corresponding to the saturation pressure at this point. That means pressure and temperature are no longer here independent, but they are dependent. So what is the first option here? If I take 1 and 2, pressure and temperature to represent the vapor in this case, then that is no longer enough here. Why? Because these are no longer independent, but they are dependent on each other. So we need to have one more parameter to identify the state, because at least we need minimum two variables or two parameters to identify the state. So that means from 1 and 2 we cannot calculate. Let's investigate the other options. So what happens if I take 1 and 3? Pressure, of course, we can know pressure from here. And 3, dryness fraction. So here, from the given pressure, automatically we can calculate the temperature. And if you know dryness fraction, then only we can calculate the other parameters. So what is the meaning of this dryness fraction? That is the amount of the water or vapor present in the mixture here. That is the water plus vapor here. That is the dryness fraction here. And if you know drainage fraction from this one, we can calculate, for example, if I want to calculate the specific volume V, that is a VF, that is specific volume of the liquid plus the drainage fraction into specific volume of the FG. This is nothing but VG minus VF. So this is the difference between the specific volume of the vapor minus specific volume of the liquid. That is this one. So to calculate the specific volume, we need this one. That means by knowing the drainage fraction, we can calculate all other parameters so that we can know the state of this particular fluid. So by knowing 1 and 3, we can know the state of the fluid. And what's about 2 and 3? And again, this is the same as the, you know, previous one. So either you know P or the T, it is the same case. Why? Because if you know the T, automatically you can calculate the corresponding saturation pressure. And the same way, if you know the P, we can calculate the, you know, corresponding saturation temperature here. And again, if you know T and the drainage fraction, you can calculate all other, you know, variables at that particular state, and you can identify that particular state and you can do analysis. And what's about 3 and 4 here? So if you know drainage fraction here and the specific volume here, if you know these two, then again, can we identify the state? Yes, we can identify the state from this one. Why? Because I know this value V, I know this value X. From these two values, I can find out the VF if I substitute this value here, and I can find out the VG. And if I know the VF here, VF is nothing but specific volume of the liquid or the water at this particular, you know, position. And this is the saturation. This is the saturation point on the dome. So if you know the saturated specific volume of the liquid or the vapor, then automatically you can go back to the steam tables and you can identify its position. So by knowing these two, you know, parameters also, we are able to find out the state of this one. So only thing that, you know, here not only option that is not giving the state of the fluid is if you know only pressure and temperature. So here option A, if I consider this vapor dome, and what happens if I consider this section? So here again we have two sections, and these two sections are, first if I consider saturated vapor means again it's a, when I keep on heat beyond the 100 degrees, then the vapor is going in this line. This is the constant pressure line. This is the P equal to C. And whenever it's going on the constant pressure line, then automatically you can find out the constant or the corresponding temperature here. So again here, P and T became independent. P and T became independent here. So in that case, what happens? Again, we need one more extra variable to find out the state of this one. So in the second case, that is in the supersaturated vapor, this pressure is no longer saturated, but initially this is a supersaturated, and there won't be any single, you know, corresponding saturated temperature for this one. Even though these two are independent here, because these two are independent here, but still we are unable to calculate the state of the fluid by knowing the pressure and temperature here. Because for every pressure in the supersaturated region, there would be, you know, so many possible temperatures here. So instead of temperature, we need one more variable here to identify the state of the fluid. So if you observe in all the cases, by simply knowing the temperature and the pressure, we are unable to specify the condition of the vapor here. So the option is here.